This is a brief discussion about how upcoming changes in the next few years to Atwood Avenue will affect Olbrich Park in Madison, Wisconsin. We have an opportunity to make some positive upgrades to the safety and usability of the park. Here is Olbrich Park today, at least that portion of it that is south of Atwood Avenue to Lake Monona, Oak Ridge Avenue and Welsh Avenue to the west, and Starkweather Creek to the east. The park is cut through the middle by an extension of Lakeland. More on that later. The green dashed lines show the common ways that neighbors use to cross into the parkland. A pedestrian trail follows the southern shoreline to a jetty into the lake and a large sculpture. At the lower left, we see the water utility building for well 8, the playground, and restrooms. More sculptures are located in the north and south corners, and boats have access to Lake Monona at two points on the shore, at least. Here are the field sports areas as proposed in the Olbrich Park Master Plan. From the shore, there are great views of the lake and sunsets over the Capitol. Most of the parkland is flat. At the west, though, the land rises fairly steeply. The grassy slope over a subterranean water reservoir has been used as for winter sledding for at least 100 years. The existing bike path here is dangerously steep, making for a challenging climb and a white-knuckle experience for any bicyclists attempting the descent. Here are the zones that show how people currently use the park. The gold-colored area is where the greatest concentration of family and neighborhood events occur, close to the playground and the restrooms, for wedding gatherings, drum circles, picnicking, musical events, and lots of other activities. Bringing wheeled traffic deep into this area of the park has always been a safety issue. So far, there are three plans proposed by the city that partially solve the problem, but these were prepared without neighborhood input. You can look them up on the City of Madison's website. Sledders zoom across Lakeland Avenue in the winter, but more importantly and dangerously, moving cars and especially fast bikes racing down the steep slope have always been a threat to park users and children in the playground area. Accidents waiting to happen. The SASY Transportation Committee is looking at a plan that would eliminate the conflicting areas and make the park safer and more usable. With wheeled through traffic eliminated, park users are on foot are safer due to separation from cars and fast bikes. The dangerous steep portion of Lakeland is reconfigured as wheelchair accessible switchbacks connecting to the pedestrian trail. So for the first time, wheelchairs and strollers will have safe and genuinely accessible entry to the park from the neighborhood to the west. Similarly, winter sledders are safer since the cross traffic will be eliminated. And the bike route on the little-traveled Oak Ridge and Welch Avenue legs are safer for bicyclists as that route follows a less severe hill incline than currently. And it is a route that will also be much better serviced in winter for hardy, cold-weather bicyclists. This route also resolves an otherwise awkward termination of the bike path at the blind corner of Oak Ridge and Atwood. This route crosses over a little-used part of the park and eases the grade there to dovetail with the major bicycling component of the Atwood reconstruction. So this plan accommodates the full wide range of Olbrich Park users and eliminates zones of potential conflicting uses. In this way, walking, picnicking, biking, and sledding park users all will see marked improvements.